Imagine shooting a film in a foreign country when you're in a plane and it goes down. That is exactly what happened to St. Louis native Dan Parris 2 years ago. Dan survived that crash, and he's here to talk about the entire incident with us. Dan, good morning to you.
Thanks.
We're
going to
talk about that in just a little bit, though. You were filming a documentary called Give a Damn. We'll talk about that. First, though, the plane went down while you were filming. The pilot and the co-pilot died in the crash. We want to first, to set this up, show a clip about the film where you document the crash, okay? Let's watch that.
There was that moment of, oh my God, this is bad, and then 2 seconds later, which felt like an eternity, we hit the power lines.
Bam, 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 bam. Just like we hit everything. It was like a roller coaster going off the tracks and just banging up against walls.
I opened my eyes and realized I was upside down. There's blood pouring down my face. There's fire around me. I have to get out of here. And I got out in probably 10 seconds, but it felt like forever.
And I remember waking up. Because I was hanging upside down, I felt like I was paralyzed. I felt like I couldn't move my legs.
And I got out and I looked back and there's no one else getting out, no one else moving. So I looked away and I looked back at the plane again and I basically thought, what you do right now matters.
The next thing I know, Rob was waking me up and he's like, the plane is on fire. The plane is on fire. You got to get out. You got to get out of here. And I'm just freaking out and I look back and I turn around behind me and I just see flames coming in my direction.
He got out, walked out, and then I looked back again and Frank and Ryan had not got out. And I said the same inner thing, like, what you do right now matters. You're going back in there. And by that time, the fire was really starting to get bad.
Now, as we said, Dan Parris joins us, and you could have a documentary, I suppose, about the plane crash. That is not why you were filming this, obviously. Where did that happen? Where did the plane crash actually go down?
It happened outside the Kibera slum, which is the second largest slum in Africa. The day before, we had walked around and met people in the slum, and were planning what we would film there. And so the next day, we wanted to get an overhead shot of the slum, and the crash happened while we were filming overhead.
So I'm guessing there is not much of an infrastructure for rescue equipment, hospitals. You had really nothing to work with once you survived, and now what was next, right?
What was amazing was that, you know, we came over there to help Africans, so to say, and the Africans that helped us, that rescued us, that helped put the fire out before the fire engine could come, and who basically dragged us in a car and drove us to the nearest hospital.
So what happened in the sort of, you know, hours and days after that? Was there a thought that the project is off, or how far along were you? Kind of talk about, you know, the events that took place and how you maybe had to reconsider what you were doing.
Yeah, it was definitely a huge moment because most of the film was supposed to take place in Africa, but we had started July 6th in St. Louis, and we had hitchhiked across America, then we had backpacked across Europe, and we were trying to live on $1.25 the whole time.
Which is the point of this movie, I guess.
The point,
right?
Of the film is, yeah, to try to see what it's like to experience poverty the best we could. So we'd been in the trip for a month, so we'd already invested a lot of time, and so turning back wasn't really an option. And the other main guy, David, and his brother, Tim, they were both there, and we decided, no, we got to continue this, we got to finish. And so I was in the hospital for 2 weeks in Africa, but
wow.
While we were there, we decided, no, this trip is going to continue. And we also decided that when I would go back to America, I'd film my recovery and my sickness. So the story, the plane crash, basically sends us all in different directions to try to finish what we started.
Interesting. Okay. Now, so there's these, obviously, you said it's the slum, people living without running water, without electricity. Let's take another look at a clip from your film, and we'll talk about that.
There was that moment of, oh my God, this is bad. And then 2 seconds later, which felt like an eternity, we hit the power lines.
All right, that's actually the same clip here. But let's talk about people who will see this, and we should mention this is premiering at the Tivoli on Sunday. We'll have more information about the dates and times on that in just a minute. But as you raise issues about poverty in Africa, and these issues have been around for so long, they don't seem to go away. Part of the mission here, I suppose, is to help people. Give people here some way to help people there. What did the movie teach you about that?
What I learned and what I discovered through about 4 years working on this project, what I think really will make a difference is people here in America figuring out what breaks their heart. What is the issue? Maybe it's not poverty. Maybe it's elderly. Maybe it's orphans. Maybe it's HIV. Whatever it is, figure out what breaks your heart and then figure out what you're good at and try to put those together. Try to take what makes you come alive, what when you do it, time just passes. So for me, for example, I wanted to give young Americans something to live for,
mm-hmm.
and I love making movies. So I put those two together. And so, like, I didn't come back like, hey, this is the one thing that'll solve it, because it's very complicated. Like you said, it's
absolutely
been wrong. But I think if everybody thought about what they could do personally and what they would enjoy doing, like, it's an opportunity, not a guilt trip. You know, this is a chance for people to really give something that they would enjoy doing. And so I think that's what I learned. And what hopefully the message of our film is, people will be inspired to say, hey, this looks like fun. Like, I can make a difference, and I could do what I love and fight what breaks my heart.
Wouldn't that be great? Okay, we're going to tell people where they can see the movie and then show that clip, because children here are such an inspiration, such a part of the movie itself, and might inspire people here to help out. If you'd like to see the premiere, it is called Give a Damn. It premieres Sunday, August 14th at 2:30. That's at the Tivoli right there in the heart of the Loop. $12 for the tickets. You will be there, Dan, I'm sure.
I will be there. There'll be a Q&A and everything.
Terrific. And if you've never been to a documentary screening where the filmmaker is there, I would advise you to go. It is a lot of fun. Dan Parris, thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Good that you survived. We're going to show you another clip of this movie here in Fox 2 News at 11 o'clock. We'll be right back.
Yeah.